Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys extremely well. Today we are discussing some questions. So let's start. Before, please subscribe my channel, like, share and please comment. So let's start. First question is, a report about a boy in the newspaper was an unexpected event in Swami's life. Justify. And the answer is, if his father hadn't read about the bravery of the village boy, he wouldn't have started comparing Swami with him. He wouldn't have challenged Swami to show his bravery. It is unfortunate for Swami that such a rare incident takes place and gets reported in the newspaper, and catches the attention of Swami's father. Yes, indeed, the report about the boy in the newspaper was an unexpected event in Swami's life. Swami made a comment on the newspaper report. Was he right? How did his view differ from that of his father? And the answer is, Swami made a comment on the newspaper report. No, he was not right. But according to his belief, to face the tiger and fight with it means definitely he should be grown up. Swami's strength and age are important to fight, but Swami's father's views was different. To support his view, he gave an example such as a man may have the strength of the elephant and yet be a coward if he doesn't fight at all, whereas another may have the strength of the straw, but if he has courage, he can do anything. Courage, strength and age are not important. Next question is, third question. What desperate attempts did Swami make to escape from his father? And the answer is, when Swami's father challenged him to sleep alone, Swami hoped that he was only joking. He mumbled yes quickly and tried to change the subject by talking about his cricket club. Swami, who was terrified of sleeping alone, tried desperately to make his father change his mind. First of all, he tried to change the topic by speaking to his father about new bats, balls, and decision of his cricket, even elders. When his father kept to his decision, he tried to postpone the date by promising to sleep alone from the first of the coming month. Next, he pretended to have Fallen asleep next to his granny with the blanket covering his face. But when his father pulled the blanket blanket away in order to sleep as the last request, he pleaded with his father to allow him to sleep in the hall instead of the office room. But all these attempts turned out to be futile, as his father reminded resolute in his decision. Fourth question is, why did Swami conclude that his father's proposition was frightful? And the answer is, Swami had a habit of sleeping beside his granny. He was afraid of sleeping alone. In this condition, Swami concluded that his father's proposition, means suggestion, was frightful, means bad. Fifth question is, as the night advanced, Swami felt that something troubled would happen to him. What would it be? How would it happen? And the answer is, when he was in the office room at night, he remembered all the devil and ghost stories. His friend Moni had seen the devil in the banyan tree. Muniswami's father spat out blood. Swami thought that something troubled would happen to him. The ghost may come and carry him away. All these thoughts made him faint. Next question is, there was absolute silence in the room. In spite of it, some noises reached Swami's ears. What were they? And the answer is, the different kinds of noises that reached his ears added to Swami's fear. In the stillness of the night, even usually sounds added to Swami's nervousness. The ticking of the clock, the rustle of trees, snoring sounds, and the humming sounds of the night were the different sounds that reached Swami's ear in the stillness of the night. Next question is, narrate Swami's dreadful experiences when he was lying under the bench. The answer is, So Swami fell asleep when he slept under the bench, he was troubled by nightmares. He dreamt of a tiger chasing him and his inability to escape as his feet were stuck to the ground and would not move. The tiger was at his back and he could hear the claws scratching the ground. There was also a loud thud. Swami desperately tried to open his eyes but could not. Finally, when he opened his eyes, he realized that he wasn't next to his granny. In this wakeful state, he was in for another horror. He could sense something moving down, and he thought it was the devil that had come to take him. In his desperation, he hugged it with all his strength and bit into it. Next question is, how was Swami honored by classmates, teachers and the headmaster? And the answer is, Swami became a hero one night. The next day morning, congratulations were showered on him. His classmates looked at him with great respect. His teachers patted his back and felt very proud of him. The headmaster spread him as he was a real Scot. Even the police were grateful to him for it. Next question is, why did the father want Swami to sleep alone in the office room? And the answer is, father wanted Swami to sleep alone in the office room to prove courage in is everything. According to Swami, age and strength were more important to adventurous tasks. But in Swami father view, the strength and age were not too important. Courage is also. To prove Swami had also courage, he should sleep alone in the office room. Next question is, who did you think was wiser, Swami or his father? Justify your preference. And the answer is, according to the prose, Swami was wiser. Swami was afraid of darkness and long lines. When he saw something was moving, he felt that his end had come. He assumed that the devil would pull him and tear him. So why should he wait? As it came nearer, he crawled out of the bench, hugged it and used his teeth like a mortal weapon. This shows at the time of emergency, he used his wisdom. By this act, he helped to catch notorious burglar. So we can justify that Swami was wiser. Next question. Why did Swami feel
relieved at the end? Answer. The answer is, when their father returned home from the club that night, he asked his wife about Swami. Swami was usually slept beside his granny. Father thought that Swami slept before he could return home to avoid him. So he said that he was very clever. For that, mother lost her temper and supported Swami and said that he can sleep wherever he likes. There is no need to take such a risk to his life again. Father mumbled that if Swami was spoiled, there is no blame on his side. By hearing that conversation, Swami felt relieved that end. Next question is question number 12. Suppose you are Swami of the story. Write a brief letter to your friend describing how you helped to catch the burglar in your house. So friends, you see the letter. And Malgudi's 10th April 2018 from Swami, second from Malgudi. His friend is Raju, son of Muniswami, second cross Vidyanagar, Madurai. So, my dear Raju, how are you? I am fine. And my parents too. My granny asks you often, how is your school and friends? I hope you are also fine there. Last week, my dad ordered me to sleep in his office room alone. You know that till end I sleep beside my granny. I was afraid very much, but I had to obey my dad. I slept alone in his office room. When I was asleep, I heard a sound. I got up and saw that there was something moving toward me. I huge it and bite with my strength. There was a cry here that the cry. My dad, servant and family members came and enough this person. There was a crying here, the cry. My dad, servant and family members came and caught the person. To our surprise, he was a notorious burglar. Like this, I hope to catch the burglar, thought. It was not my intention. I am expecting your early reply. Convey my regard to your family members. Your lovely friend, Swami. Next question is, some words describing the characters of the story, a hero, are given a brackets. Put them in these columns appropriately. Caring, protective, innocent, tricky, authoritative, disciplined, helpless, nervous. First is Swami's father. Disciplined, authoritative. Authoritative. Second is mother, caring and protective. Third is granny, innocent. Fourth one is Swami, tricky, helpless, nervous. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. Jai Hind.